Hello to everyone. Thank you to assist my presentation. I am Ricardo Rocha and I came from INEGI. The title of my work is Numerical Analysis by XFEM of Hybrid Tibial Joints. The other colleagues that helped me in this work are Rogério Faria, Raul Campillo, Paulo Gonçalves and Isidro Sanchez. This is the outlook of my presentation, which includes a brief description of adhesive bonded joints and the extended finite element method, XFEM. Then I will address the experimental work describing the materials, joint architecture, test setup and results. The numerical work follows, where I will present the modeling conditions, the applied criteria for damage initiation and propagation, and comment the results. Finally, the conclusions. So, the main objective is the validation of XFEM methodology to predict the performance of welded, adhesively bonded, and hybrid joints. The experimental data retrieved from previous work in the literature will be used to validate the numerical model developing this work. Numerically evaluate the failure in the different joints with adhesives with distinct ductility grid, like the AV138 and 2015 from Araldit and the SikaForce 7752. Then study the joint's behavior with different damage initiation and propagation criteria and also evaluate the dissipated energy. By observing the upper picture, one may notice the components of an adhesive joint. The materials to be bonded are called substrates. However, after bonding, the term generally used is adherent. The region between the adhesive and the adherent is referred as the interface. A primer, in blue, is a substance that is often applied on the substrate to improve adhesion or protect the surfaces until the adhesive or sealant application. This joint method is used in several fields such as aeronautic, aerospace, marine, electric industry. It can also be found in simpler industries like furniture or shoemakers. Regarding the XFEM, it relies on damage laws based on the bulk strength of materials to characterize the damage initiation. XFEM formulation is available in finite element analysis softwares like Abacus. The XFEM improved the finite element modeling since it can predict strains and damage initiation along a random path, considering the damage laws related to the strength of materials, therefore evaluating joint failure. This method relies on the implementation of local functions around the crack area, which could capture the near-tip structure of the crack and the displacement jump. This method has been applied in the context of bonded joints to evaluate crack patterns and strength prediction. In this work, three structural adhesives were tested in the bonded and hybrid joints. The Araldit AV138 is a brittle epoxy adhesive, but with high strength. The 2015 is a ductile epoxy adhesive that, although showing smaller mechanical properties than the AV138, due to its ductility, it enables improved load transfer at highly loaded regimes. The 7752 is a ductile polyurethane-based adhesive with smaller strength than the former adhesives but with high elongation. As the adherent, we select the C45E carbon steel. The joint geometry study under peel loads is depicted here on your left, and it was built through welding, adhesively bonded and hybrid, that includes welded and bonded. The most relevant joint dimensions are shown here in this table. Adherent thickness 2 mm, joint width 25, adhesive thickness 0.2, bonded length 90 mm, adherent radius 1 mm. The spot welded position is defined by A and B, made equal to 12.5 mm. 5 specimens were tested for each type of joint at room temperature in an electromechanical tester, equipped with a 100 kN load cell and a velocity of 1 mm per minute. This slide plots the average experimental values of maximum load and respective standard deviation for all joints. Comparing the bonded joints that are the orange, blue and light green and the welded joints at gray, it's noteworthy that the best performance was achieved by the welded joints. In fact, the maximum load decreases around 60% with the adhesive bonded joints when compared with the spot welded joint. This lower resistance of bonded joint occurs due to the premature failure of the adhesive layer at the joint's loaded end, in relation to the weld nugget failure in the welded joints. Among the T-pill bonded joints, the 7752 presented the best performance, with around 1.3 kN. The comparison between the welded and the hybrid joints. So the hybrid joints are the red, blue and dark green. It reveals a visible maximum load improvement for the hybrid joints. Actually, the hybrid joints manage to accommodate stresses more evenly than the welded joints, while enabling further regions of load transfer between the adherence and the non-welded portion. Adding a spot weld to the bonded joints, this is the hybrid joints, enables a major PM improvement. Comparing them with the bonded joints, improvements above 250% were found. These hybrid joints' enhanced performance can be explained by the fact that after the failure of the adhesive layer between the joint's loaded end and the vicinity of the welded nugget, the adhesive near to the weld nugget also has an effective role in the transmitted load between the adherents. Now, regarding the imposed numerical conditions, we use three-dimensional models. Longitudinal symmetry conditions were applied to diminish computational effort. The hybrid joint elements, adhesive, adherent and welding point were modeled as solid. And for the adhesive, an XFAM formulation was applied for the simulation of the damage initiation and propagation. This slide presents the boundary conditions imposed to reproduce the experimental testing. The plane of symmetry through the adhesive thickness was clamped, the specimen was restrained in its width direction, the adherent free edge was constrained in the joint longitudinal direction and subjected to a traction displacement. Regarding the mesh assigned for the adhesive joints, mesh size grading was applied to the thickness in the adherence and in the direction of the adhesive layer. The refinement in the vicinity of the adhesive layer is important because there is higher stress concentrations in this location. Now for the hybrid joints, higher mesh refinement was assigned in the adhesive, in the contact surface between the adherent and the adhesive, and also in the welding point. This slide presents the damage criteria. There are 6 crack initiation criteria available in Abaqus software. And regarding the stress-based ones, we have the maximum principal stress, max-PS, the maximum nominal stress, max-S, and the quadratic nominal stress, quad-S. Regarding the strain-based ones, the maximum principal strain, max-PE, the maximum nominal strain, max-E, and the quadratic nominal strain, quad-E criteria. Once one of these criteria become valid, the material stiffness initiates the degradation process. Regarding the damage propagation, the damage laws that simulate the material's degradation up to fracture can be linear or exponential. In this damage criteria evaluation, a linear law was applied. All although varying the initiation criteria, the full behavior up to failure was modeling using a linear softening and a power law factor equal to 1. The validation of this study was performed through comparison with the experimental data regarding maximum load. It was found that all strain-based criteria largely failed the strain prediction, especially for the welded joints. Considering the stress-based criteria, the max PS criterion underpredicts the maximum load. On the other hand, the quad S and max S criteria presented very close results to the experiments. Actually, the quad S is the one that correlates best with experimental data, presenting a maximum deviation around 4% for the hybrid bonded joints with 7752 adhesive, and marginally smaller deviations for the other adhesives. Application of this criterion to the spot welded results in deviations under 3%. The max S criterion shows slightly higher deviations than the quad S, with a maximum deviation around 5% for the spot welded joint and a minimum around 2.5% for the hybrid joint bonded with the 7752. Now, for the hybrid joints evaluation, it was found that all strain-based criteria largely failed the strain prediction, as in the previous analysis. Considering the stress-based criteria, the max PS criterion underpredicts the maximum load. In addition, the quad S correlates once more best with experimental data, presenting a maximum deviation under 3% for hybrid joints. Regarding the max S criterion, it shows slightly higher deviations than the quad S, with a minimum deviation of 2.6% for the hybrid joints bonded with the 7752. This slide presents the evaluation of the most suitable damage propagation criteria. In relation to the damage initiation for the hybrid joints, the quad S criterion was applied due to the good accuracy as concluded in the previous slides. One may notice that the maximum load over prediction attained by the exponential softening law. The obtained predictions were much more accurate using a power law criterion with linear softening law, and the best results were found for a factor of 0.5. Nonetheless, the outcomes were very similar for factors equal to 1 and 2. The deviations for a factor equal to 1 were in the interval between 1 and 4.1, and for a factor equal to 2, deviations were almost identical. Similar to the previous slide, the obtained predictions were much more accurate using the power law criterion with linear softening law, and the best results were found for a factor of 0.5. In fact, the absolute maximum load deviations to the experimental data were between 0.5 and 3.6%. This slide presents the dissipated energy analysis. For each joint, both numerically and experimentally, the dissipated energy was defined as the area under the P-delta curves. One can verify that numerical values of dissipated energy are lower than the experimental ones. Nevertheless, for the hybrid joints, similar results were found. These deviations are due to the effect caused by the machine clearance, which prone to occur higher displacements until joint failure. Through the analysis of different damage initiation criteria, it was possible to conclude that the XFAM is an accurate tool for the maximum load prediction of TPL joints by applying both quad S and max S damage initiation criteria. in brittle and ductile adhesives. Regarding the damage propagation, it was concluded that the linear power law criterion is capable to accurately predict the maximum load, while the exponential law largely overestimates it. High deviations of dissipated energy values between the numerical and experimental tests were found. The adhesive ductility affects the dissipated energy. By increasing the ductility of the adhesives, it will increase their plasticity, and therefore it increases the dissipated energy. Thank you very much.